Hello friends, in today's episode we look into the best 100% working method to repel slugs and snails in your garden. And most importantly, it's 100% humane because you're not killing these creatures. Let's build this inexpensive DIY slugs and snail fence and see what happens when they try to cross this barrier. Coming up. Slugs and snails are actually cute looking creatures, but they eat away a lot of your garden, leaving only plant or leaf skeletons. They are active during the night and really difficult to get rid of. In our previous episodes, we discussed so many natural methods to control slugs and snails. In this episode, we'll discuss on the barrier or the fence method using copper wire or copper tape and show you the 100% effective electric fence method. Some of you might be worried hearing the word electric. Do not worry, it's 100% safe for humans and even pets because we're using just a 9-volt battery which does not cause any electric shock and it is in fact inexpensive, permanent and 100% working method. Inexpensive, yes, indeed, because the battery will not be consumed unless the slugs and snails complete the circuit by trying to cross this barrier. Well, many companies even sell some slugs and snails copper tapes and claim they repel these creatures. No doubt copper is a repellent for slugs and snails, but there has to be a good concentration of copper in the tapes, and also the tape has to be more than 2 inches wide to create the copper repelling effect on the snails. Now, let's quickly build this DIY slugs and snails electric fence in 3 simple steps. But before that, let's list out few basic things you need. A 9-volt battery with its connecting wires. You can also try using a 3-volt battery, especially for smaller pots, but the best effect is seen with a 9-volt battery. Then a bare or non-insulated copper wire or any bare metallic wire, preferably a galvanized wire because it resists corrosion. You can also strip some copper wires from old electric wires if you have some. Then you need a small plastic container as a battery holder. You can even use a small glass bottle to build a waterproof housing for the battery. Then optionally you may need a soldering gun, glue gun, wire cutters, staplers, particularly if you're installing on wooden containers or raised beds. Then you may also need some insulation tape and any other stuff as required. Step 1. Waterproofing the battery housing. For better durability and waterproofing, place the battery into a plastic container or any glass container and seal any openings to make it waterproof. Use a glue gun or any other method as you wish. Try to make a downward loop of the wire so that the water does not get into the unit. Then step 2. Wrap the copper wire around the containers in 2 parallel lines. Make sure the distance between these 2 lines is not more than 2 cm and also make sure they do not touch each other. This can even be installed on raised beds or wooden pots using staplers. You can also stick copper tapes in a similar fashion, especially if you use plastic containers. These copper tapes come in one-sided stickers and easy to fix on plastic pots. Then after fixing these 2 lines, you can solder the wires from the battery, 1 to each track, and fix the battery housing to the container properly to avoid water exposure and any extreme weather conditions. Then step 3, the connections. It's simple. Take both ends of the top wire and twist them together. Do the same with the bottom wire. Connect one line to the positive terminal of the battery and the other line to the negative terminal. That's it. It's now an open circuit and not consuming any battery power. You can optionally check the continuity of the wires or the copper tape if you have a multimeter and also the voltage running through the line. You can be more creative here and add lines connecting from multiple containers to a single battery to make it more cost effective. If you have any more suggestions or creative ideas to make it more durable, please let us know in the comment section below. Now, let's see what happens when slugs and snails try to cross this fence. You know, these are slimy, wet creatures, and when they try to cross the track, they complete the circuit and get a nice shock and get repelled. So, there you have it folks, please hit a thumbs up if you found this video helpful, also share this with your friends and comment below with your feedback and queries. Consider subscribing if you're new to the channel. Happy organic gardening!